بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. A key dimension of the successful movement of Imam Hussain عليه السلام is the role of women, both before his martyrdom as well as the aftermath of the 10th of Muharram. Perhaps what is not well known is the identity and achievements, for example, of some of these females, including the wives of Sayyid al-Shuhada alayhi salam. Despite continuous attempts by Bani Umayyah to confuse history on their identity by encouraging fabricated stories and testimonies, we are able to get a general idea of who they were and some important aspects of their lives. Four women are documented in historical sources as being the wives of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. Indeed, there may have been others. Number one, Shahr Banu, the daughter of Yazdajard III. She is the mother of Imam Ali al-Sajjad, peace be upon him. There is much discussion in historical records regarding her real name, her date of marriage, and when she passed away. There is a popular opinion that she was a slave girl captured after the defeat of the Persians during the Khilafah of Umar ibn al-Khattab, the second Khalifa, and that she chose to marry Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam after being taken to Medina. However, the date for this would make the age of Imam Zain al-Abidin 36 in Karbala on the 10th, which is not accepted by many historians. Hence, as suggested by Sheikh al-Mufid, she was sent by Huraith ibn Jabir to Imam Ali alayhi salam in the year 37 after Hijrah. She then married the Imam alayhi salam. Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr married her sister as well. Unfortunately though, after giving birth to Imam al-Sajjad, she died. 2. Umm Ishaq bint Talha al-Tamimi. This honorable lady was initially the wife of Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam. Her daughter Fatima later married Imam al-Sajjad alayhi salam, and therefore Fatima is the mother of Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam. Before his martyrdom, Imam al-Hasan asked his brother Imam al-Hussein to marry Umm Ishaq after him. She was a devoted female who was likely to have been present in Karbala and was taken as one of the captives by the army of Yazid. She had one daughter from Imam al-Hussein by the name of Fatima. 3. Arraba bint Amr ibn al-Qais. She was an outstanding lady known for her eloquence, beauty and courage. Arrabab was the mother of Sukayna and Ali al-Asghar, according to many historians and scholars. She was very much beloved to Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. It is narrated that he wrote the following lines of poetry about her and his daughter Sukayna. I swear, I love the house in which Arrabab and Sukayna are living. I love them dearly and I sacrifice all my belongings to them, and no one can disapprove my admiration towards them. This great lady was a witness to the tragedy of Karbala and was amongst the captives paraded from one city to another. It is said that she held the holy head of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam in the palace of Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad and said, "Oh Hussein, I will never forget you. Your body was hurt by the enemy's spears. They betrayed him in Karbala and martyred him." When Arrabab came back to Medina, she was offered requests for marriage, yet she refused them all. She said, "I want no other father-in-law after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam." In Al-Kafi, it is narrated that Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam said, when Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam was martyred, his Kilabiya wife held mourning ceremonies and they all wept for Imam until their tears became dry, except for one of the servants who is still constantly weeping for Imam. When they asked her about the reason, she replied, "I drank the sawiq syrup." Afterwards, she ordered to prepare, the wife of Imam al-Hussein ordered to prepare the syrup, and it helped people weep for Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. Arrabab passed away a year after Ashura. Layla bint Abi Murra bint Urwa ibn Mas'ud al-Thaqafi. Layla was the mother of Ali al-Akbar, peace be upon him. She is paternally from the Thaqafi tribe and maternally from Banu Umayyah. Despite some suggestions that she was not present in Karbala, it is likely that she was. Layla had a close relationship with her son Ali, prayed for him, saw him according to some narrations before his martyrdom, and was later part of the caravan of captives that was taken away from Karbala and paraded from one city to another. She was known for her nobility and upright character. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the souls of the wives of Imam Al-Hussein, who dedicated their lives, who brought up these righteous children in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say, 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 say